Pulitzer Prize winner Kendrick Lamar. First non-classical guy to do it.
Mm-hmm. Posted about it yesterday. They said hip hop wouldn't last.
First jazz and non-classic, non-jazz, non-classic. A lot of those non-classic, a lot of the classical and jazz people are hating on it. Who cares, man?
Yeah, man.
I remember Bob Dylan won a, what was the award he won? Was it a Nobel? What was it, Bob Dylan? Doesn't matter. It is what it is.
Anyway.
Yeah. They hating on it. Because I think people have always stigmatized what hip-hop is as a culture, as a music.
Mm-hmm.
You know, always tried to put parameters on it. Bob Dylan won a Nobel Peace Prize is what it was. And there was a lot of, you know, activists and humanitarians that were like, how come you do that? You're selling out, you know, you're diluting the purpose of the prize. Mm-hmm. And whatever. You know, but you can't put these limitations and ceilings on what we do that's coming out of this culture. So Kendrick speaking and creating these musical compositions is as important as some of these classical or jazz musicians who created their projects. And his project actually is impacting people, and he's representing a voice of the voiceless, you know, especially mm-hmm. in this climate and in these times, speaking to what we're seeing socially in our country. That project, Damn, was right at the nucleus and very timely that it was happening. So to me, it's only fitting, in my opinion, that someone like Kendrick Lamar would win this Pulitzer Prize. And when I think of my next guest who's sitting here right next to me, this dude has always redefined what it is we do and always walked beyond the perimeters of expectation. I remember when he first came up with the visual mixtape, mm-hmm. the first person to put out a visual mixtape, ladies and gentlemen, in a DVD form, that went by the name of the N1 mixtape. And what he did with that is he combined athletics with music and culture and put it all together and created that N1 mixtape movement. And then after all of that, when you start seeing the Smack DVDs and all mm-hmm. those sort of things, this was at the beginning, at the genesis of that movement, and that was done by my good friend representing Philadelphia, if I may.
It's Queens originally, but you know.
Okay, well, whatever.
50-50.
Okay, all right, Queens. Okay, Queens and Philadelphia. Give it up for Setfree, ladies and gentlemen.
Setfree was popping.
Hello, everybody. I'm just happy to be here, that's all.
All right, Tracy, you want to ask something?
Yeah, but when you were talking about Kendrick, uh-huh. I wanted to say that the two other nominees who are composers, they actually really celebrate Kendrick winning this award. It's really wow. the fans
uh-huh.
that are upset about it, but they've both gone on record. They did interviews with Slate and said they feel like this is huge for not only hip-hop, but music as a whole.
As a whole, see, mm-hmm. you know. Setfree, what up, man?
I'm blessed, man. I'm in a happy state, man.
Okay, why is that, Setfree?
I'm alive, first of all. I'll do that. But I'm just, you know, I'm in another lane, like you said, creating art and toys, and connecting it with hip-hop, and the response that I got has just been overwhelming, man.
Why was that important to you, especially putting a highlight on art and hip-hop?
You know, art doesn't get... It doesn't get to just do it supposed to get in a lot of cultures. And, like, when you think about it, you look at, like, two of the greatest logos in hip-hop is the Wu-Tang logo and mm-hmm. The Public Enemy logo.
Mm-hmm.
And who's the artist? We don't even know who made those mm-hmm. logos. And it's somebody home that was like, yo, I created that Wu logo.
Yeah.
The Wu-Tang logo is the third biggest logo in the world. It's McDonald's, Jordan, and the Wu-Tang logo.
Okay.
And, wow. You know, you think of characters we all grew up on, like the Red Man logo.
Uh-huh. Well, who created the Wu-Tang logo?
I don't know.
DJ Mathematics.
There it is.
Wow.
And then I think RZA has the rights to
congratulations
it.
Congratulations to Mathematics.
Okay,
like,
okay.
And I just felt, you know.
Public Enemy. Did Chuck do that?
Eric Hayes did it. A lot of the stuff for Def Jam. I'm not sure.
Damn,
Rosie Perez's husband, right?
Well, yeah.
Okay.
So
let's look that up.
You know, so I felt it was like an opportunity to create art and create sculptures with some of my favorite artists and connect them with the hip hop culture.
So the Compound is a creative agency that you created, right?
Correct.
Talk about the Compound. All this falls under the umbrella of
the Compound. Yeah, okay. The Compound basically it was started as my office,
mm-hmm.
Where I was doing a lot of marketing with all of my clients coming up. It has a studio. It has like a green screen photo shoot area. This is a war room to do creative, but all my friends in the industry, from athletes, artists to actors, musicians, started coming up to do their work on the project. And I've been collecting toys forever in art. So it's basically like a creative art studio. I always felt that, you know, growing up, you went to Chungking, you went to Green Street, but music was always over here. So you went to a real studio, you never got motivated. You only got motivated to do music, but you didn't look around and something inspired you in the room to do put that in your record. Photography studios was just always like a white room with a psych, and it was nothing inspiring in there. So I came up with the concept of like, wait, if you got all these creative people in here, they should be able to feed off the room. They should be able to turn around and look at a jersey in the room that's signed by their favorite player. They should be able to look at their favorite artist. They should be able to look at vintage album covers. So it was basically a space that I created that put all these cultures in one room.
Setfree is here, man. What's your social media if people want to talk to you and find out more?
It's IM_Setfree. And then the compounds, the compound underscore.
This project, you got a toy set called the Ganja Grin toy set, which is available tomorrow,
4:20.
What is in that set?
What is in it?
Yeah, what is that?
it's a toy. SpongeBob was a character that a lot of people, I heard, because I don't smoke, but I heard a lot of people watch SpongeBob as they was high. So I was like, wow, let me take SpongeBob and make a marijuana plant with SpongeBob and connect them together. So it's been working, man.
Yeah.
It's working. And the toy drops tomorrow, and then we did a record also that I'm super excited about.
The record is called, Setfree Presents Compound Smoke Project, right?
Correct.
And then who some of the artists you have on it?
One record called Inhale Exhale. We got Smoke Dizza, Dave East, Currency, and Styles P. My thought process with that, we never had an East Coast smoke record with a lot of people.
Yeah.
You had Styles did one by himself, then you had Meth and Red. And I was like, yo, all my fans, they smoke. You know, we smoke on the East Coast.
Yeah.
And the Chronic is like a hailed project in hip hop for the West Coast. So I know I'm not creating a Chronic, but at least, you know, I felt that I could put a good record together with all the people on the East Coast that smoke and then give it some light.
Had to be.
But what does the toy do?
The toy just looks at you. It's a piece of art. That's what art just look
it's
at
like
you.
It's like a sculpture.
It's a sculpture. It just look at you.
You got a lot of pretty colors. I see purples, lime greens,
yeah, it's
some
actually,
magentas.
It's, you know, it's sour diesel and haze, the purple.
Oh,
SpongeBob
okay.
With three eyes.
Yeah.
Yeah, the three eyes, you know, Styles even said, he was like, I love it. He was like, you know, it got the third eye. He was like, it got two noses to smell the bullshit. You know, so it's just art. It's just something you put in your studio, you put in your house, and all the weed heads love it. They like, yo, I want one. I just want to smoke and stare at it.
I find it interesting that you said you don't smoke, but you took an interest in, like, putting something out for people who do and who entertain or whatever like that. Because, I have smoked, but I don't.
Uh-huh.
And to me, because we have Cheech and Chong actually coming by on Monday.
Oh, wow.
And I look at them as the kind of the pioneers of, like, making
totally,
weed
totally.
Cool.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Who would you say as far as weed culture? Because now everybody's on Instagram like, oh, I got pounds and fucking bags.
I mean, like, I know, like, Seth Rogen, Willie Nelson, Meth and Red in our culture. I mean,
Snoop.
Say Snoop,
right.
Man.
Snoop, the president, of
Wiz.
Course.
Yeah, yeah.
Wiz.
And Rihanna, too.
Rihanna, exactly. Some NBA players, I can't say them, but there's a couple. Shouts out to Rasheed Wallace, you know. He was definitely.
Rasheed is my dude.
That's
man.
Our guy.
Yeah,
like,
man.
You know, they was called, the Portland Jailblazers at one point for smoking? Yeah.
They was ahead of their time.
They was way ahead of their time.
Yeah, that's all, man. Vanguard's in the game. Buddha and Grants produced this album?
They produced, actually, the Inhale Exhale track.
Uh-huh.
And then I put another, just one of their tracks on there because, you know, a lot of albums you wish it was just like a dope instrumental on there and you could just vibe out to a beat, especially a lot of people that smoke, sometimes they don't even want to hear nobody rhyme. They just want to vibe to the melody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I put in one of their tracks on there called Smoke Break.
How long is the Smoke Break track? Is it like 8? 12 minutes.
Yeah, nah, we let it rock way beyond a regular song. It's like four and some change.
Okay, Sean's on the line from Oakland. Speaking of smoking. Oakland. Hey. What up, Sean?
I just had a question for Setfree.
Yes.
Oh, what's up, Sway? You know I'm from East Oakland like you, so I just want to say peace.
You know, already know what it is, Sean.
Yeah, I'm on this 580 doing too much. Okay. But, yeah, I wanted to ask you a question, Setfree.
What up?
About that East Coast smoke record you said you was making.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I'm like coastal. I always come to New York, whatever. And I'm a smoker, of course, because I'm from Cali. y'all don't have a good weed, though. Oh. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
You know, I mean,
you know what? I can't even. I don't
know how good y'all can rap about some good smoke when the smoke ain't that good on the East Coast.
Wow.
You know, he's not the person to talk
to. I'm not the person.
Buddha, come here. All right, because you know what? I got a lot of family members that come to town, friends that have come to town that say the exact same thing about East Coast.
So let me just answer a question, then I'll let Buddha talk about the smoke. I just wanted to make a record that the weed culture is on the East Coast, though. And, you know, the artists that we picked to do the record, they all got heavy lungs. So, you know, we felt that these are the people that could represent the record and the smoking culture on the East Coast the best.
You're not even a smoker. Get
so
out of here.
So, Buddha now.
Buddha, come here. Let's talk to a smoker.
Yes, sir.
Buddha, say hi to Sean.
Hi, Sean.
Okay. Have you smoked on the West Coast, too?
All the time.
Slow your roll, Sean. I'm talking to Buddha. Sean got buds falling out her mouth. All right. Why is it? Is there a difference?
I mean, there is a difference in quality, but I feel like in the last 2 years, New York has been making a resurgence in the bud game because of all these other states around New York that's been legal.
And they're getting it from other places.
Exactly. Either Denver, Boston, Miami.
L.A.
D.C. All these spots is legal. So
yeah.
Now the
Seattle.
The access is a lot better.
Uh-huh.
And then it depends where you went to. Because I'm sure if you ain't go uptown to Dykeman or something, you definitely going to find some fire over there.
Yo, see, y'all fire is not our fire, though.
Y'all
like that loud green. We like that sticky purple. No sticks, no stems, no seeds.
I agree with you. I'm a purple guy myself. I'm a kush guy.
We could, yeah, you know see, mean? Kush, no. Kush can go in Oakland. Cookies, purple.
I mean, of course, you always got to do some cookies.
Test, you know what I'm saying?
I don't understand none of this shit.
That's a different language.
It is a different language, but y'all are pioneers of the weed game. Nobody's saying that y'all not.
No, I'm not saying it.
Okay.
I was wondering how the heck could they talk about trees that's not really that good.
But you smoked all the weed in New York already?
Yeah, I'm bi-coastal, Yeah.
That's a lot of weed.
It's not good. Yeah, it is.
Hey, Sean, what's your Instagram?
Herb is good.
She ain't even listening.
Sean, what's your Instagram?
Yeah. She hot
now.
Wait, hold on. Everybody, hold up. Sean, what's your Instagram?
It's Sincere I Am 77.
She sound like straight up Oakland, Heather. That's you know, she know what she talking
about.
I am.
And no, I'm not high right now, but I will be in a minute.
How you spell sincere?
Like sincere, S-I-N-C-E-R-E.
S-I-N-C-E-R-E? Underscore.
Yes.
Oh, okay. I am. All right. Thank you, Sean, for belittling his whole concept.
Trashing all of New York.
Oh, no. Thank you. Just got to check y'all, man. Let's play this song, man. We'll come back with a couple of headlines, all right? This song is called Inhale, Exhale.
Hey,
you can get it off the Set Free Presents Compound Smoke Project. It's going to be everywhere. It's everywhere?
Yes, sir.
All right.
It's a plot press. Sure as I ever been, you hate me. Well, God bless. Trying to play the game, but you ain't got no cards left. I'll be all over your bitch ass.
Sway in the morning. Chrissy Brinkley just walked in, ladies and gentlemen. Let her bring it on mic. Legendary. Heather, do the honors here. Do the honors, Heather.
Hello,
Chrissy. How you doing?
I'm doing great.
It is so wonderful to
Even
see you.
Even better coming in here with all the music.
This is where the music is at.
Yeah.
You know, this is our friend Setfree. He creates. He does.
Hello.
He does
How
art,
are you?
Music, and culture. This is one of his our art pieces that he created.
That I love that.
Yeah, and
I love it.
It's a SpongeBob marijuana plant.
I love it. It's too. Oh, that is sick.
You know, 420s tomorrow. So you got a new collection coming.
God, when is that coming? What?
This is coming out tomorrow. It's due tomorrow.
Where do you get that?
It's online at my website is thecompound.com. But me and Ron English, you remember Ron English? He's a famous painter.
Yeah.
Me and him did a collaboration and made a toy and art. art and paintings and stuff.
I love it.
Oh, thank you so
I
much.
I love it.
Christy, we'll get you
one. This is going to be huge in California.
Yeah, we just.
Now, what brings you to town? What's going on with you?
I'm sort of running around promoting my new makeup line.
Okay.
Beautiful. And Christy Brinkley, authentic. Yeah. Oh, yes. I've got a Bellissima fan over here.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so anyway, I'll just say my Christy Brinkley authentic beauty. .com/ available at Kohl's. But also, we were just talking about my Bellissima because I'm on my way to Las Vegas next week for the Wine and Spirits Convention. Okay. It'll be my second time there. I have a line of organic, vegan, the most delicious Prosecco, right? She can vouch for me.
Uh-huh.
It is the most delicious Prosecco you can't even imagine. And I'm coming out with the little mini bottles, you know, with the little sippy cup on top. So you can just like, you know, drink it,
just
wander
take it
back.
To the head.
And I'm gonna introduce two new liqueurs that you mix with it.
Uh-huh.
So I'm going to have my own Bella Spritz, which is going to be the drink of the summer, I guarantee you.
Wow.
It is so refreshing. And then I'm also coming out with another one with elderberry in it. And it's so refreshing. Wait till you taste that.
Okay.
That's how to be.
Wait till you taste it. It's like... I'm not kidding you. I'll come here with it.
You promise?
Yeah, and we'll pop the bottles.
On air. Okay.
And we'll just like party. I mean, it'll be so great.
Okay, man.
Because you
won't
believe. And it's like, you just, it's like, you know, when you add that little mix, it's just like, oh, it's so good.
Wow.
Yeah.
Then you sold the hell out of that.
Yeah, shit, man. Yeah.
I wasn't even a drinker till now. You know, so, hey, man. Wow. Well, Christy Brinkley, man, thank you for coming to Sway on the Morning.
Oh, thank you so much. And I got to get one of those. I know exactly the person that needs that.
Okay. Wow. Christy Brinkley is here. You hear that? You like that? I remember the video. Hey. Dylan, we're doing the video right now. Hey. That's what's up. Sway in the Morning, man.
Yeah.
Thank you, Christy. You look amazing, too. You look, see, how do you maintain
so
it?
Much.
You maintain it really well. You look beautiful.
Bellissima. Right.
Is that the drink? Drink
that? So fun. Okay. Thank you for letting me crash.
Absolutely. Anytime, man. Anytime. Christy Brinkley just walked in and walked on out. I love how she just bogarted your interview, Setfree.
Okay.
Sad. What are you doing? You live on air, man. She's not going to give you her number, bro.
It's okay. She just want a plan. I just want to give her a plan.
Give her a plan.
Give her
that
plan.
One.
Definitely, we will.
Okay,
cool. All right, cool. Thank you, Chris.
It happens live. This way in the morning.
You should have gave her that one for the camera.
Why you didn't give her that one, man?
What are you doing?
Give her this one.
Did you give her this one?
It's the prototype.
It's the proto, yeah, but we'll do it.
Who else are you going to give it to, bro? Christy.
You can take this
is from Setfree.
You can take that. Yes. Oh, my God.
Yeah, take that. Go ahead. Yeah, get that. There you go. Yeah, you can get that. Yo, Setfree, get in the picture,
though. You might want to drop that Starbucks. We don't want to do that now. Yeah, you get in the middle.
Okay, so Christy Brinkley right now is getting herself one-of-a-kind piece of artwork. SpongeBob SquarePants, the 420 edition. Looking beautiful right here.
Yeah.
How much does that retail for, first of all?
Wow, $6.50, but $3.99 on this wonderful Thursday on this 420 Eve.
Nice. Follow Christy Brinkley because she's on Twitter popping all the time. She talks about a lot of powerful things on her social media. Follow her on Twitter as well. Bye, Christy.
Yeah. Thank you.
Bellissima.
One.
That's a great look.
Yo, man, what you doing?
Let it go.
Yo, Setfree was acting like he didn't want to give it a
try. You know what it is, Sway? You always, he doesn't come here enough. And you always tell people to recognize the moment and be present. That was your moment.
It was the moment.
TMZ follow her around. You're going to have to do
that. It was the moment. It was the proto. And it was the proto. I was like,
nigga?
He was like, yo. He was trying to give it a hat.
No, I wasn't going to give her a hat. I was going to be like, oh, God, but it's okay.
Dog, look, she walks around town. With that plant,
it's over.
Yeah, and it's going to become a conversation piece.
Yeah, like Christy got a weed plant with a SpongeBob on it. It's out of here.
Yes, there you
that's
go.
That's why you big bro,
but you, yeah, but you was getting mad at me. Like, no, I ain't giving her the plant.
Like, you know what? I got to go a couple more spots and give it a plant now. But it's okay.
You know why it's no spot, no plant?
Because this was the only spot to be.
Because
at.
One of the biggest models in the world in history is carrying your plant.
Job is done. Job is done. Only on Sway in the Morning.
What other rap show are you going to go to that's going to give
exactly.
you that?
Exactly. Why didn't your demo, fam?
There's no rap show that's going
to
do that.
Buddha introduced you to Young M.A. We get Young M.A. to carry it.
No, we going to be all
that's
right.
That's family. You know, you good?
I'm good. I'm so good.
Just bring out a picture.
Oh, damn, man. Yeah. Who's fighting me?
It costs $650?
Yeah, it's costing $650.
It's a collector's item. It's a limited edition.
Got it.
It's only 1,000 of them going to be done.
Damn.
Wow.
Yeah.
999.
Pretty much, right? It's worth it, though.
Hey, but you want to see the plant that Christie Brinkley just ripped off Setfree, just go ahead to his website.
Yeah, and www.cmpd.com.
Yeah.
That's fire, though.
You know when somebody really mad, though, when, like, they leg keep shaking and everything.
I'm like,
you good, though.
No, I'm good. It's not even at the moment. I'm good. It's bigger than giving the plan away. I get it.
The sacrifice is worth it, bro.
The sacrifice is way bigger than
that. You got the photo.
Yeah, the photo. We got everything.
Sway's a bully, man.
I like that. Oakland came out and he's like, get that plant up, dog.
Always.
He's like, now.
Motherfucker. He's like, you can do this Christy Brinkley. You know.
I get it. I'm good. You know
what it is, Free? You got it. You were factoring in too much, and Sway was just trying to tell you she's not going to go home and get on her computer and do all of that. It needed to happen right then and there, and I need that leg to stop shaking.
All right, Ma, it's stopped.
You only got one. You only got one plant, dog.
No, we ready to go now.
Okay, all right.
Tomorrow, everything shipped from Hong Kong. We ready.
Are you going to see her in the live and try to take it back?
Nah, she got it, man.
She got knocked on the window.
She says she knows who the plant goes to already, so it's gone.
Okay. She's holding it. She's walking with the plant. Film her holding the plant. Yo, look at that.
She got the plant.
The plant's gone. She's ready for that plant. Yeah, something about to happen with that plant. It's a good thing, though.
He said the plant's gone.
He said the plant is gone.
How do I say goodbye?
Oh, that's the plant is really gone.
The plant is good. Yo, any final words to the plant?
The plant is all right, man. It's going to grow. That's what plants do.
Sometimes you got to let them seeds blossom on their own, man.
You're right, man. It's just art, man.
You put the seeds in the soil.
It's time to let the blessings come, right?
Let Christy Brinkley water those seeds.
And let it grow, man.
And let it grow. When she walks outside of this building and all those TMZ photographers out there.
With that plant. You're right.
You take ownership of that moment.
It's so hard. The plant is gone. It's in good hands, though. It's in good hands with Allstate.
To the plant. Setfree, ladies and gentlemen. Hit them up on social media.
I am_Setfree. And then go check out our world, The Compound_.
We're going to say thank you to Leonard Ellaby. Don't forget Saturday night, showtime, 6 p.m. on the West Coast, 9 p.m. on the East Coast. Make sure you see TMT Presents Boxing on Showtime. Three classic fights that are going to take place. Devontae Davis will be fighting, and Adrian Broner will be fighting. Jamal Charlo will be there as well. Make sure you watch that. Also, we want to thank Dr. Ian Smith for coming by today. We're going to be doing our Clean 20 Challenge starting May 1st. 20 days, 20 foods that are great for you and witness the transformation. You can hit him up directly, too.
At Dr. Ian Smith. It's Dr. all spelled out. Dr. Ian Smith.
Okay, OQ, how can they reach you?
You can check me on Instagram, OQ Shoots, and tomorrow we got Antonio Banderas stopping by.
Wow.
Desperado?
Big show.
Wow. Okay. Wow.
Also, don't forget, Saturday night, there's another big thing happening. My show at Caroline's, the 12 midnight. Shit. You can go get tickets at carolines.com right now or go to It's Really DB on Twitter and Instagram. Use the promo code midnight if you want to get $10 off. Be there.
Right after the fight, go to the comedy club. Tracy G.
Nice, and I will be there to support DB. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, at It's Tracy G, ITS, her ACYG. Love you, citizens.
It's Thursday. Another episode of Terrible coming out today on Sway's Universe and at DJ Wonder on Instagram. I still have to edit the whole damn thing. So it's going to be down to the wire, folks.
Okay.
Citizens, I'm on my way to 70K, 500 more people, and I'm at 70,000. Follow me at the Happy Hour WHB. It's Soul Food Thursday tonight on SiriusXM Fly, starting at 6 p.m. Eastern.
All right, I'm at Real Sway. You can see Pee Wee Longway. We put that up today. Also, David Blaine, scaring the whole room, performing tricks. We're going to post that today on Sway's Universe as well. And you can also see Reef. Comedy, who won our comedy show.
Sharif Johnson, he just had his breakout artist night at Caroline's, and he just became engaged, proposed to his girlfriend on stage after a set.
Okay, all these things can be found on Sway's Universe and our conversation with the one and only Agunda Okeyo, the one who put together the Sisters of Comedy series that you see out and about. We posted that as well. I can be reached at Real Sway across the board in Sway's Universe.
Can people get these hats? Because these are dope.
Yeah, exactly. Tomorrow on the same website, thecpmd.com.
Thank you.
CPMD.com. Yep. Why does Setfree look sad, man?
Yo. I'm good. I'm so good, y'all.
It's setting in
I'm
now.
I'm good. I'm taking it off. It's a big moment. I'm happy. I okay. just say, okay. I'm good. Processing.
It's
yeah.
how Buddha looking at him. You know, you look over your man's, ain't really supporting your move.
Well, that was his.
I'm trusting the process.
That was
like,
his
she
plan.
She took my plan.
Moments, baby. Moments.
It's a great moment. Okay, thank moment. Y'all. Thank
All right.
y'all.
And until tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen, we have nothing left to say.